If you are a 360 VR or VR180 videographer, one of the first questions you will ask yourself when you begin this professionally, aka producing for a paid client, is what frame rate you should shoot, edit, and deliver in. This is not an easy question to answer, and you probably wouldn't find a straight answer on the internet. Today, in the second episode of the 360 VR Filmmaking Beginners class, we are going to discuss the pros and cons of filming and delivering 60 FPS VR live action videos. I will show you a newly released technology that allows you to play up to 6K by 6K stereoscopic 3D 260 video in 60 frames per second. And the crazy part is, you don't need to shoot at 60 frames per second. You can shoot at 30 FPS and convert it into 60 frames per second. It's better to show than tell. You won't be able to see the differences until you watch my samples in your VR headset. So go ahead and download my sample and let's discuss. Hey everyone, it's Hugh here from Creator Up, the number one YouTube channel dedicated to immersive VR filmmaking for everyone. This is part of the free videos in my upcoming 360 filmmaking masterclass on LinkedIn Learning. Let's get to the point. 30 FPS versus 60 FPS. Which is better for VR video? Your distribution is what decides the frame rates. If you primarily distribute on YouTube and Facebook as a shareable 360 video on browser and mobile devices, then 30 frames per second is more than enough. If you aim for a VR headset delivery, then you should try to make it 60 frames per second. Either shoot at 60 frames per second or convert it into 60 frames per second. VR headsets like Oculus Quest or Oculus Go right here had a refresh rate of 60Hz or 72Hz. 30 frames per second video decodes and updates 30 frames per second. Despite the fact that the VR headset and VR screen refresh 60 times per second. So if your video can be played at 60 frames per second, it will sync with the screen refresh rate closely and produce a smoother viewing experience. If you have lots of motion in your video or your camera is moving, 60 frames per second will help reduce ghosting effects and motion sickness. Gamers know this and consider the frame rate is a huge factor in image quality, and they are probably your first viewers when they are bored with Beat Sabers. Don't take my words for it, ask your gamer friends to watch your video. Shooting and editing at 60 frames per second in 3D is not that easy. Even if you are just doing VR180, not many cameras can shoot at 60 frames per second and still keep a resolution above 4K. Your Instar 360 Evo or the upcoming Instar 360 ONE R is not going to be able to do it. In 360, you need a professional camera like the Instar 360 Pro 2 right here, the Titan, the Canon Obsidian S, Zcam V1 Pro, or the retired Google E Halo. They are expensive, but I have a review on all this camera on my YouTube channel if you are considering buying one. So check out the list down in the description down below. Even though you have those camera, shooting in 60 frames per second in general will not look as good as 30 frames per second in terms of pixel resolution and stitching buffer. Some cameras, like the Instar 360 Titan right here, has some strange aliasing issue when shooting in 60 frames per second. You will need to take this into consideration. Talk to your stitcher and your post-production supervisor. They need to know you are shooting in 60 frames per second and that the stitching is going to be more challenged, especially in 3D. On the distribution side, you will hit another wall. In both Oculus TV and YouTube VR, the resolution will be significantly reduced due to bandwidth issue. Watching over the internet, like streaming services, it is not ideal for 60 frames per second just yet. Oculus TV is probably the best services on streaming 60 frames per second 3D 360 videos. With the help of the Facebook team, my recent 60 frames per second dance music video looks great on Oculus TV. You can check it out for free in your VR glasses if you click this link right here. But even with Oculus TV on Oculus Quest, the resolution is probably half of what a 30 frames per second video. So it is a trade-off. So for now, 60 frames per second is better for local viewing. But even with that, your Oculus Quest will hit a wall and start dropping frames with your Cydo 4K by 4K 60 frames per second video. If you are not sure of the video resolution spec of your Oculus Quest, please refer to this video or the official Oculus documentation. If you want to render 60 frames per second for Oculus Quest or Go, the best resolution is 3072 by 3072. Above that, you will have playback issue. According to the hardware limit, the max resolution can actually go up to 3072 by 3840. If you want extra pixel for your top and bottom, you can go with this secret resolution. But then, not all players can play back non-square top and bottom video correctly, so just take this into consideration. This short video will not help you with the capture and post-production side of things. That is why I designed my 20 hours full masterclass to help you with that. But we can tackle the playback side of things with a free plugin from Visbit. Yes, I repeat, it is free. Visbit Player and Encoder Lite for content creators. First, you will need a 6K, which is 6144 by 6144 3D 360 video or above in 60 frames per second to achieve the best image quality. GoPro Max new firmware just released allow you to shoot at 3K 60 frames per second. Install 360 One Art can also shoot at 3K in 60 frames per second. Use that too to test the power of 60 frames per second. It's free, why not? Download the Visbit encoder for your PC or Mac, drop in your video and convert it from H.264 or H.265 MP4 to Visbit BVOS file. Now go ahead and download the Visbit Player Lite on Oculus Store onto your Oculus Go or Oculus Quest. Set up your VVOS file using a USB cable and Android file transfer if you're on a Mac. For PC, computer, you can just drag and drop a VVOS file onto your movie folder like so. Put on your VR headset and you should see your video play in 60 frames per second within your newly downloaded Visbit Player Lite. That is a great way to show the absolute best video quality to your clients. If you make a virtual tour video, this is a great value add, as now your video can look as good as your 360 photos, and it can be 3D. Simply send the VVOS file to your clients, they can view it too on their Oculus headset. It is that simple. Convert 30 frames per second into 60 frames per second with Visbit DeepSmooth. It's not everyone can shoot and edit at 60 frames per second. It requires a professional VR camera like right here, a very high spec computer or a server farm, and a knowledgeable team to pull this off. For individual or small size production company, you can always just pay Visbit to convert your 30 frames per second VR video into 60 frames per second. The quality is surprisingly good. I was very skeptical when they first approached me and want to convert my monoscopic 360 travel video into 60 frames per second. I knew what I was doing and I thought that 60 frames per second is not necessary for travel VR video as most of the action is far away with stationary camera. Well, they proved me wrong. When I saw what they sent back, it was incredible. 60 frames per second looks so much better even for far away moving objects like cars and people. Now, instead of getting a Zcam K2 Pro, which costs around $8,000, I can simply use my Insta360 Evo and convert it into 60 frames per second using Visbit DeepSmooth services. It's way cheaper and easier, so yes, don't throw away your Insta360 Evo just yet. This might bring new life to your VR180 production as well. I think the future of live action 360 immersive video will be directing towards a gaming VR experience. 24 frames per second is not cinematic at all in VR, and even 30 frames per second makes viewers suffer from motion sickness. In the upcoming years, display technology will continue to become better and VR storytelling will become more popular. Learning with me now will give you the knowledge in the future. If you are new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell to stay up to date. If you have any question, please comment below and let me know. I will see you in the next tutorial or in virtual reality real soon.
When people think of Abu Dhabi, they often picture that, giant, shiny skyscrapers coming out of the sand. However, it also has a very rich history going back over 250 years, and here we are at one of the oldest standing structures, Qasr Al Hasan. Let's go take a look. We are now standing underneath the dome of Louvre Abu Dhabi. We've brought you here in VR to try to give you a glimpse into what this is like. You really have to be here to experience it.
Yay!
This is Hugh, everybody.
Yeah, so we are going to the Louvre right now to capture some 360. They're actually not allowed to film, but we get a film permit. Kind of get some amazing VR shot, so you can experience the museum just as what we experience. So this is pretty amazing museum. It's on the water, so we'll see.
So we're filming 360, and here we have Christina. What are you doing?
Hiding. Half our day is spent hiding. I'm hiding my hand over here.
Hiding Dirk, over there.
Our sounder hiding over there. We have Hugh and Love hiding over there.
Everyone hiding. Of-